Everyone, it is Shannon, and I'm super excited to be here today and to share with you my TBR for the All the World's a Page readathon, which is a Shakespeare readathon that's happening for the entire month of July. The readathon is hosted by Olivia from Olivia's Catastrophe, Julia from Shakespeare and Such, and Kara from Wild Book Garden. I will leave links to their announcement videos down below for you to check out. I can't wait to get started. I can't wait to get started. Now, the readathon has three different levels that you can participate in. There's a beginner level, intermediate level, and an advanced level, as well as some bonus challenges. And what I've actually decided to do, and I hope this is okay, I am going to do independent study, and I am going to pick one challenge from each of the levels, including the bonus level, and have that create my TBR. Or in some cases, TBW for to be watched, because there is a little bit of that in there as well, which is where we're going to start. So from the beginner level, I am going to watch a Shakespeare adaptation, and for that I am going to watch Coriolanus, and this is the Stratford Festival production. Stratford is a Shakespeare festival here in Canada, Ontario, actually, Stratford, Ontario, they have been filming their productions and then releasing them on the CBC website, or the app, the CBC Gem app. And Coriolanus is one that went up fairly recently, and it is available on the site. Now, unfortunately, I think the site is geo-blocked to Canada only, but they do have a rotation of plays that they are putting on the Stratford YouTube channel, and I think King John, Hamlet, Antony and Cleopatra is going up soon, and then there's one other that is going on. So they're because of COVID, they've had to close their season, but they are putting some on the YouTube channel. The Coriolanus was on the YouTube channel, but unfortunately it doesn't look like it's there anymore, but it is available on the CBC Gem app, and I do want to watch all of the productions. Pericles, that's it. Pericles is also available on the YouTube channel. So yeah, but I'm gonna go with Coriolanus. This version was directed by Robert Lepage, who is formidable. I saw him direct Macbeth, the Scotch play. A couple of, well, I'm not in a theater, so it doesn't count. So I saw a production of Macbeth that he directed many, many years ago at Hart House. He's a formidable director, and I've heard really good things about this production. My sister saw it at Stratford when it was part of their season, and she highly recommended it, so I can't wait to watch it. So that is the adaptation that I will be watching. From the intermediate level, one of the challenges is to reread a favorite, and I am going to reread the Scottish play, which is one that I actually do an annual reread of, and I don't know if I feel quite comfortable saying that it's my favorite, but generally speaking, I think it is because I reread it every year, and I don't actually know why because the story is so harsh, but there's so much interesting in it, and the characters are great. Lady Macbeth is awesome, like horribly awesome, but awesome nonetheless, and they're. I don't know. And there's like some magic stuff with the witches and the premonition-ish prediction-y thing. I don't know. It's all like I just really, really like Macbeth. So I am going to reread that. I haven't read it this year for my, so it made sense for it to be my annual reread. I do think I'm also going to listen to an audiobook version of Richard III with Kenneth Branagh playing Richard III, I think, and it is available on Scribd. It's a full cast production, and he is like the first name. So I am assuming this is actually from a theater production, but I'm assuming he plays Richard III. I love Richard III. It is super dark, and it's one of the histories, but it's very, very good. And I would highly recommend the Ian McKellen film adaptation. It's one of the best film adaptations I've seen. So I think I'll listen to the audiobook version of that. So that'll be rereading Richard III. I haven't read it for several years, and it's a bit of a weird one to jump into because it's like the last of the two history tetralogies. So, but anyway, it's a great story. So, well, great. I don't know, this great is a little that's a little interpretive. So, but those are the two favorites that I am going to reread. From the advanced level, one of the challenges to read a speculative retelling, and I'm taking a bit of some leeway with this one, and I'm going to read Station 11 by Emily St. John Mandel. Now, this is not a retelling of a play, but it is a speculative setting, if I understand correctly. I do not know much about this one, but I think it follows a Shakespeare troupe But I'm not sure where they are or what's going on or what the world is. I have very much avoided any spoilers on this one, so I am hoping to read it without hearing anything about it, because the thing that I really know pretty much is that I want to read it, and I've had it for years and I don't know why I haven't read it yet. So I don't know, maybe I was waiting till I finished all the plays. That could have been the reason. We'll say that's the reason. So yeah, so I am looking forward to finally reading Station 11. Then for the bonus challenge, I am going to read a nonfiction or critical analysis. And I'm going to do something I have never done before, which is I'm actually going to read the introduction and notes at the end. There's a whole section here on Lady Macbeth. I have never done that. Whenever I read a play, any play, pretty much, I just read the middle. I just do not read the intro, but, you know, and I just start here with the cast of characters. So this time I'm actually going to, I'll probably read the play first and then read everything else, because otherwise it will sort of inform my view of it, which I don't like to do, which is the reason I don't read that. I just read the play and then I don't, which is why often my interpretation of things is a little creative. So, but I'm curious to do that because I've never actually read any critical analysis, and I thought it was a really interesting choice for one of the challenges. So I'm really curious to see how that is going to go. So that's what I'm going to do for that one. And I have set a couple of bonus challenges for myself because there are just some other Shakespeare related things that I want to do or want to watch or want to read. So I'm just going to like add them in here as like bonus challenges. And the first one is to actually finally watch Ophelia, which is based on it's a film, and there was a book that was written by Lisa Klein, and the film, I read it as a book to film challenge book for last year. I think I finished it this year though, and so it is Hamlet retelling but from Ophelia's perspective, and then it takes some liberties, and I was actually, to be honest, I wasn't a huge fan of the book, but I'm really curious to see the adaptation. Daisy Ridley plays Ophelia. She's from the new Star Wars movies. And I'm curious to see what it's about. I can't remember who else is in it. This doesn't say, because this is about the book. This is the film tie-in cover. But it's actually now available, at least here in Canada, it's available on Netflix. So I am very excited about that. For a long time, I think it did like the festival circuit, and then there was like no information. It's also available on Hoopla. And so I was going to watch it there, but now it's on Netflix, so I'm going to watch it there so it doesn't take a credit. So I'm going to watch that. I'm also going to watch The King, which is, I think it's a Netflix original film, but it might have been at Con. I think it's a sort of a loosely based on Henry IV Part 1 and 2, as well as Henry V. The King character, who is played by it doesn't have his name here. Yeah, there, Timothy Charlemagne? I'm not totally sure. I have not seen him in anything yet, which makes me feel like out of it, but whatever. he plays like the Henry V character, or the Hal character, and the Dauphin is played by Robert Pattinson, and Joel Edgerton plays Falstaff. So I haven't actually heard too much about this. It came out last summer, I think, on Netflix, and I was super excited. I think it was just, I this is the silliest thing, but it's over 2 hours, and I rarely pick movies that are over 2 hours. Like, I'm always looking for something that's an hour and a half, an hour and 45 minutes. So, but I really want to see this. So all I have to do is just like, you know, start watching it a little earlier in the day and I will be fine. So anyway, let me know. Have you seen The King? Did you like it? I'm a huge fan of the director, who is David Michaud, who did Animal Kingdom, which is an Australian film, which was formidable. I'll watch anything that he does, and I'll watch anything that any of the actors from Animal Kingdom will do. And Joel Edgerton was in that as well. So like anyone who was involved in that, I'll watch it, because it was harsh. So there's that. I haven't seen the TV show though, so that's Animal Kingdom, the movie. I am off topic. Okay, back to it. Other bonus stuff. I actually decided, I also think I am going to read Edward the Third. Now, this is accredited to anonymous, but noted, like, but it's kind of considered that it likely was written by Shakespeare, so I figured That would be a fun thing to add because I did finish reading all of the works of Shakespeare in April, so I don't have anything new to read. So I thought this would be as close as I can get. So we don't know for sure either way if he wrote it, but even if he had just a part in it, I thought it would be fun to do that. This is a history, so yeah. So and which I am on it with the histories, I'm on and off, but this one is not attributed to him directly, but could partially be his. And then also, I think one of the things earlier this year, I did read the sonnets and I did underline tons of them and I really enjoyed them, but I read them rather quickly. So I thought it might be fun to revisit them or potentially do like some art with that, like with a scene from it, like an art scene inspired by one of the sonnets, or do a quote, like do just a page with like a quote. Maybe something will come up in Macbeth or Edward III, just do some art because I've been trying to get back to doing art. I haven't been doing as much recently, and I miss it. So I thought if I threw in a bonus challenge here, it'll inspire me to do that. And I'll make a little checklist for my whole TBR, and then it'll be looking at me saying, "Shannon, do some art." So yeah, so either a sonnet, scene from a sonnet, or a quote from one of the plays, I don't know, or maybe from the film, maybe do something drawn from inspired by one of the films watching. I don't know. I don't know. Just do some art. Basically, just do some art. This is Shannon do art. So yeah, so that is my TBR and TBW for the All the World's a Page readathon. Let me know if you are participating. Let me know if you enjoy reading or watching Shakespeare. I really do. I had a blast going through all the plays. I didn't love all of them. Some stand out, of course, more than others. But I definitely was a fan of the tragedies. And I did like Henry IV Part 1 too, and Henry V is excellent. The Kenneth Branagh version of Henry V is so many memorable lines that are used again and again, Star Trek, and just generally. Yeah, so let me know if you're participating. Let me know your favorite adaptation. And if you don't read Shakespeare, let me know why not? Like what there's I understand that it's not for everyone, and not everyone has to be, like there's certain genres and stuff that I don't read, but I feel like there's so much interesting, and it's amazing that there's works that have been around for so long, yet the themes are still part of life, and I think some of the plays come in and out of fashion because of the themes. Like Coriolanus is one that goes sort of like not, it's not as present. But like Hamlet is just like indecision. That's always apparently. I don't like Hamlet. I'm not a big fan. It's very low on the list. I didn't tier rank Shakespeare. I wonder if there is a tier ranking for Shakespeare. That would be interesting. Anyway, now I am just blathering on. So let me know if you are participating. Let me know your favorite adaptation. Yeah, and I'm looking forward to checking out everyone else's TBRs and see what they will be reading and watching. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll be back soon with another video.